So coming to the radical neck dissection, so this surgery we have already studied one more previous cancer. So which was that cancer? If you remember, just message me. So radical neck dissection may be performed along with laryngectomy when metastasis is suspected. So surgeon will be removing the salivary gland, the sternocleidomastoid muscle, internal jugular vein, as well as spinal accessory nerves. So this is very extensive surgery so that we can prevent the nodal spread. We can do selective dissections, modified dissections, conservative or functional neck dissections. So this is one of the picture which shows after the surgical procedure. You can see the incision. Here what will happen is, due to this surgery, major portions are being removed. The trapezius muscle which is supporting the shoulder will be go atrophy. So due to that, a drooping of the shoulder to one side, the affected side may be seen in some persons. So the physical therapist or nurse can assist patients with range of motion exercises as soon as after the surgery. Otherwise, the function of the lost muscles cannot be regained. Mid Fowler's position is the best position because it will reduce the facial edema. It can also improve the circulation and reduce or prevent headaches from lymphedema. There are some reconstructive surgery. In past cases, we are using skin graft. Nowadays, we are using myocutaneous flaps as well as free flaps. That is to reconstruct the deficits which is caused by the resection. So myocutaneous flap means we are using axial blood supply. The flaps which have axial blood supply, which supplies to the muscle mass as well as the cutaneous as well as subcutaneous tissue. That means the inclusion of muscle with its blood supply when transferring the skin allows for much greater range of rotation of the flap. So along with the muscle blood supply, we are taking the flap. So pectoralis major, latissimus dorsi, trapezius, sternocleidomastoid muscles can be used as myocutaneous flap. Muscles as well as cutaneous flap along with blood supply. We are just keeping over the deficit area and we are suturing. So coming to the free flaps, what we are doing is we are using harvested tissue which is separated from donor site along with vein and artery. Here after we place, the vein and artery will be anastomosed to the patient's vein and artery. That is the difference. So here while doing this procedure, it is termed as microvascular anastomosis, a very difficult procedure. Low dose of aspirin as well as heparin will prevent the formation of clot so that further damage to the flap will not occur. Coming to the nursing management, preoperative care. So we know that after laryngectomy, patient will not be able to take breath through total laryngectomy. The patient is not able to take breath through the nose. Always the patient use tracheostomy opening. So we have to inform the patient there will be a permanent opening over the neck, as well as the patient will not be able to speak. So it is not easy. Already the patient will be under stress because of the cancerous issue. Again, before the surgery, if you are telling these things, how the patient will feel? Very depression. Patient will go depressed. So it need an expert speaker to just break the bad news. Okay, so patient should meet a speech pathologist before the surgery to learn about the options for post-operative rehabilitation and speech. So what are the speech options there? What all things happen to the patient? What all things can be done by the patient in order to survive these things? So in some cases, we will arrange a visit from another person who undergone the same surgery successfully. But sometimes after seeing those patients, the patients again will get depressed. So selection of the time is critical. So sometimes a visit of that patient can lead to depression again. So careful assessment must be done to handle and fix that when the patient should meet. Either we can plan before the surgery or after the surgery, according to the patient's adaptability to the situation. After talking, we will be understanding how the patient can adapt the situation or accept the situation. Otherwise, we can refer the patient to lost code clubs as well as new voice club. So these are clubs which is only for total laryngectomy patients, or any surgery after laryngectomy, or those who lost the cord and not able to speak. So the patients can register through the net and can be a member, and almost all the new technologies, all those things will be discussed over there. Local speech rehabilitation centers supply instructive films as well as other resources. So that also should be arranged and shown to the person. Care of patient after total laryngectomy. So elevate the head end of the bed 45 degree. Encourage deep breathing every 4 hours. Assess the patency of the airway. Maintain the oxygen saturation, or maintain oxygen to tracheostomy collar. We have to use tracheostomy opening only, right? So assess vitals, the quality rate of respiration and skin color should be assessed for pallor as well as cyanosis. Auscultate the lungs every shift as needed. So provide care for suture line. So assess suture line and stoma site every 4 hours. So how much time? Every 4 hours we have to repeat the thing. We have to assess the suture line as well as stoma site. Report any erythema, purulent discharge or hematoma. Monitor the drain function. Of course, drain will be there, so we have to calculate the output. So maintain the suction to drain at level ordered, and milk the tubing of the drain every 1 to 2 hours if prescribed only for 24 hours, then every 4 hours. Every 1 to 2 hours for 24 hours, then every 4 hours should be done. So report changes in amount and color of the drainage or air leakage. So clean the stoma site and suture line with hydrogen peroxide, normal saline, and dry it with dry gauze. So all these things same as what the care of the surgical wound, same as that. Attention to fluid, food and hygiene. So monitor the hydration level and ensure adequate fluid intake. So provide mouth care at least 3 times a day. Record intake and output every shift. Weigh the patient daily and provide stoma care every shift. Administer enteral feeding as ordered. Assess the patient's tolerance to feeding. Assess the bowel sounds every shift as needed. So these are our general points. Okay. So report any intolerance to feeding like nausea and vomiting, as well as fullness of feeling of fullness. Record the amount, consistency and frequency of the stools also. Assess the swallowing ability and provide support when oral diet resumes. So these are the general points. So provide support and education for the patient and family. So these are readable points you can read. So we can instruct about the use of artificial speech device as well as encourage its use. There are availability of artificial speech device will be dealing in next slide. We can provide a writing material as well as picture board so that the patient can use it for communicating. So prepare patient for discharge as usual. Teach the care after laryngectomy. So after going to home, patient can do the same. Information about the diet, about the management of airway, and refer the patient to speech pathologist to maintain his voice as well as speech rehabilitation. We can provide an instruction, a written instruction in the form of booklet so that the patient go and read if he is having any doubt. So here speech rehabilitation, tracheoesophageal speech as well as artificial larynx or electrolarynx can be used. So in TEP, what we are doing is we will be creating a puncture between trachea and esophagus. And through this puncture, we will create a fistula with the help of a prosthesis. So this is the prosthesis. And by closing this opening, permanent tracheostomy closing, and if the patient is trying to speak, what will happen? The air movement will be in a waveform and can create some amount of voice. Similarly, instead of using the thumb, the patient can use some type of adjustable valve. Otherwise, there is availability of artificial larynx or electrolarynx. So this is electrolarynx. The patient will be having electronic voice, like the patient, the robot is speaking. So complications like hematoma, wound adhesions, tissue loss, fistulas, rupture,